seconds. But last day, we discussed about Villiers' approach to calculate the total displacements of a truss. The prerequisite was that we have to solve the truss, we have to get the bar forces, we have to know that to what extent the individual bars elongate or contract. And we plotted them as a certain scale to get the displacements of the different nodes with respect to a certain difference. This was the thing which we learned the last time. Now we also mentioned that in order to plot Villiers' diagram, we have to have one point which will not move and one direction which will not rotate. Do you remember? We have to have one point which will be fixed, which it will not move, and we have to have one direction or one member, or maybe there is no member connecting those two nodes, but that those two nodes must define a different direction. Now see, if you take this sort of a truss, want to get the displacements of different nodal points of this type of a truss, then you face a certain problem. The problem is that you initially solve the truss, you get the bar forces, you know the natures, whether they are tensile or compressive, you know the individual elongations and contractions. That's not a problem. Now, this point A is definitely a fixed point, it won't move because this is an edge. But in this particular class, we cannot get any one member or any one direction which is fixed. You can get the direction ED fixed, but they are not connected by a single member, they are connected by two members. So this is the problem. Why more connection was required at all? So this is the major problem which we get, and we have to start the problem. We will initially assume that AE, that member AE, remains horizontal, which is a wrong assumption. But we have to start, let us see what we do at the end. But the point, fixed point, fixed direction, lane, তাই আমি প্রবলেমটা নিয়ে এগোতেই পারবো আমি এগোতেই পারবো কিন্তু আমি কি করলাম আমি এই ডিরেকশনটা ফিক্স তো ধরতে পারছি But initially I am assuming that this direction is fixed. Now if you go on solving like this, you will mind that this particular point D is coming somewhere here. Let's see that. I mean, tell the steps, I am not telling that because you know that. You will find that the point D, you will get somewhere there. So if it is true, then it means that this is basically the resultant displacement of D, which means this is the amount of horizontal displacement of D, and this is the amount of vertical displacement of D. Now, if I accept that the D point can have horizontal displacement with respect to A, we cannot accept the fact that if you have a vertical displacement, because both of them are at the same level, you get the question. We cannot start with a member which we know whose direction will not change. So that was the problem. So to start with, we initiate the issue that say A has not rotated, as if E does not have any vertical displacement, as if E has only horizontal displacement. So the elongation of A member that we have plotted, and we have located the point E, knowing fully well that this E is not the correct position of E. Which I do not have any objection about, because this is a moment, this can move in the horizontal direction, I don't mind. But that D seems to be this distance above A, which I cannot accept, because A and D are at the same level. So, now Bohr gave us an issue. Bohr told, see, for all the points, do not take the reference point always at A. In the Euler diagram, always we took the reference point, the particular point. At a point in respect of your reference point. More told, that fine, you can accept the horizontal displacement. You are not comfortable with the vertical displacement. Fine. What you do is, you take a point here as D and think that D1 is the displacement of D. Means D is the reference point. But our which in the diagram, what we did the last day, all the displacements last are net displacements. So all they were measured with respect to a particular one single point. Economy could be here, the irrespective of the key, the D point has gone up, which is not acceptable to me. By having voted it up, the last DL Jota, eight hour. You got that? Theta uthe gets, what does it mean? Theta uthe gets, theta positive ekhane chole esche, theta positive ekhane chole esche, according to Euler diagram, according to Euler diagram, theta uthe gets,
like
theta uthe gets, with respect to A, which I cannot accept, so I decide. So Bohr suggested, you take the reference again through an anti-clockwise direction. What is theta? Ekhane thakar kotha uthe geche. Tar mane ei rekhi, tar mane oi jaygate anti-clockwise direction hoyeche. Tahole cholare kaj kor. Protire reference point ta tumi anti-clockwise direction kore. We have told that you just got the class in a certain scale on this line. We like that ratio. A right are open because A is the reference assumption.
Thank you. charge but also moving up. So, one theta taken time. Now, Bohr said that on this particular line, AD, you draw the cross in scale, means actual AD, this particular length should be mapped with this length. And B, C, E, these are the references. Means eta, reflection of A is nothing but A, A1. It may have horizontal, vertical components or both. Reflection of B is not AB1. As you did in Miller diagram, she was reflection of B is BB1. B1 is the coordination, I said. BB1 is the displacement of B. Take it with respect to B. The displacement of C is not AC1, it is CC1. And the displacement of G is not AD1, it is GG1. In order to make the Wheeler diagram work, we have to have a single fixed point, we have to have a single fixed diagram. But in some cases, like in the case of this Warren truss, we do not have a fixed direction, although we have a fixed point. So initially we start with the assumption that let the member AB not rotate, which is not a correct. Let the point E not show any vertical movement, which is not correct. But there is no way out for me. So you start plotting AE, you get the point. Now once you get E, when those two points are known, then can you look at B? Right? Now once B is known, E is known, so then you can look at C. Now once C is known, E was known, so now we can look at D. ঠিক আছে ধরে নাও একটাই আমরা পাপ কাজ করেছি আমরা ধরে নিয়েছি যে E পয়েন্টটা যেন একই লেভেল আর কিছু কোনো পাপ করি না এটা করতে গিয়ে আমরা দেখলাম ওই পাপের পরিণাম হলো D পয়েন্টটা উঠে গেছে উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু A দ্য D পয়েন্ট হ্যাজ গন আপ উইচ ক্যানট বি দ্য কেস সো হোয়াট মোর সাজেস্টেড ওয়াজ ও বলো ডোন্ট টেক AD1 as a displacement of D1. The vertical displacement with respect to A is not acceptable. The horizontal displacement is acceptable. So, to maintain the horizontal displacement in toto, intact, but to kill the vertical displacement, you shift the reference for D up to that level. Okay, the reference is A. Then the horizontal displacement is preserved, with the vertical displacement is killed. It vanishes. That means, এখন প্রত্যেকটা পয়েন্টের জন্য দ্য রেফারেন্সটা ইউনিক হবে না নট উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু এ সবগুলো উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু ডিফারেন্ট ডিফারেন্ট ইয়েস রেফারেন্স সো দে হ্যাভ টোল্ড মোর টোল্ড দ্যাট ইউ প্লট দ্য ট্রাস ইন আ সার্টেন স্কেল অন দ্য লাইন এ ওয়ান ডি নাও ইয়ার কোয়েশ্চেন ইজ যে স্যার আমি লেফট ডে আনবো না রাইট ডে আনবো তার লজিকটা আমি তোমাকে বললাম ডি ওয়ানটা উঠে গেছে মানে কি অ্যাজ ইফ তুমি ট্রাসটাকে একটা ইনঅ্যাডভার্টেন্ট অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ রোটেশন দিয়েছো ভেবে দেখো ডিমান্ডের তো ওঠার কথা না ডিমান্ড ওখানে আছে মানে অ্যাজ ইফ কেউ একটা ট্রাস্টটাকে রোটেট করেছে তাই জন্য আমি এই রেফারেন্সটাকেও রোটেট করে দিই তাহলে ওই বিলটি ডিসপ্লেস হতে ভ্যানিশ করে তাই জন্য আমরা ওইটার উপরে আমরা ট্রাস্টটাকে রোটেট করে একটা অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ রোটেশন দিয়ে আমি ট্রাস্টটাকে প্লট করব অ্যান্ড অল দ্য ডিসপ্লেসমেন্ট শুড বি উইথ রেসপেক্ট টু দ্য ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল পয়েন্টস মানে এ ডি ওয়ান ইজ নট দ্য ডিসপ্লেসমেন্ট অফ ডি ওয়ান D1 is the displacement of E1. AD1 is not the displacement of E1. E1 is the displacement of E1. Like it. Toma sarika se na onko na kore toma koro. Otra adhi, situ na ka kichu kore. Kyo ha se na?